ideas to see whether insect pollination can buffer the negative effects of drought. So if we can raise yield of the drought plants by having insect pollination.
Åkte du tåg mellan Uppsala och Stockholm i somras? Då kanske du funderade på vad som hände i burarna som du såg från fönstret. Nu kan du få svaret på det. Här växer åkerböna. I hälften av burarna så får de vatten 3 gånger i veckan. Men i andra hälften har de inte fått en droppe vatten på hela sommaren. Och Chloe, hon vill testa hur vädret påverkar pollineringen. Och till sin hjälp har hon ett gäng mörka jordhumlor.
I want to see if the bumblebees behave differently if the plant is suffering from water stress or not. So do they pollinate more plants? Do they stay longer on plants? How often do they visit the plants? And then the bumblebees also have different behaviors. So they can either pollinate by actually entering the front of the flower, or they visit extra floral nectaries, which are below the actual flowers and are just secreting nectar, and so they don't contribute to pollination. Or they rob nectar from the back of the flower, which also doesn't contribute to pollination. So I want to see if their behavior changes depending on the water stress. What I do now is I time for 10 minutes and I'm just observing how many bumblebees are landing on either these 10 plants here or the 10 yellow plants that are free of aphids.
Chloe testar också om det har betydelse för pollineringen om åkerbönan har angripits av bladlöss. I vanliga fall så gör vi ju allt för att våra grödor inte ska bli angripna av bladlöss. Men Chloe, hon hade motsatt problem.
Because there were some natural enemies that were inside the cages when we put them up. So some were still eggs that hatched, like lady beetles and lacewing larvae. And they find these plants really quickly and then start eating the aphids. So I've had a bit of a battle between me and the natural enemies over the past week, where I've been adding more and more aphids and they've been eating them up. But finally, I think I'm winning and I feel like the plants look nicely infested.
Vi får skörd av åkerböna även utan humlor, men pollinering kan höja skörden med uppåt 30% enligt Chloes försök. Åkerbönorna är rika på protein och är ett svenskt alternativ till importerade sojabönor.
They're mostly being used for feed for cows and pigs, but in other countries they're also an important food source for people. So that's maybe something that will also come in Sweden in the future.